This is the source code for the original Doom, specifically the Linux version. And this is Chocrete Doom, the Windows port we are going to work with today. We are going to build it in Visual Studio, run it, and of course we make a few changes. First, you need the sources. Clone Chocrete Doom somewhere convenient. I'm putting mine into Documents, Doom Choco. The original release source code was tightly connected to Linux. This port replaces the audio and rendering backends with SDL counterparts to make it compatible with today's systems. Well, Chocrete Doom isn't just a way to play a game. It is a historical preservation project. Its goal is essentially bug-for-bug compatibility with the original 1993 DOS executable. It deliberately maintains the limits and quirks of the old engine. So by compiling this, you are building a digital museum piece. Let's get into build. You'll need Visual Studio and CMake. Visual Studio will be our working environment. And CMake? Think of CMake as a blueprint maker. It looks at the raw source code and generates a project file specifically for your version or build files for basically anything you want. It saves us hours of manual configuration. Next, we need to handle the dependencies. As I mentioned, Chocrete Doom is built on top of SDL or Simple Direct Media Layer. This is the library that makes your life easier if you want to work with graphics, sounds, and networking in C++. Go to SDL website and download the development libraries for SDL2, SDL2.NET, and SDL2 Mixer. Make sure you grab the Visual C++ versions. Unzip those into your working directory and double check that Windows didn't leave you with nested folders to prevent surprises with unfound files. Now, launch the CMake GUI. Point the source code to the folder we just downloaded. For the build binaries, create a new folder called build inside your working directory. Hit configure, choose your version of Visual Studio and set the platform to Win32. Here is where 90% of people get stuck. You are going to see a bunch of red errors saying library not found. This is normal. CMake is smart, but it's not a mind reader. It doesn't know where you put those SDL folders we downloaded earlier. You need to manually copy the file path for SDL2 there, SDL2 Mixer there, and SDL2.NET there. Copy it into CMake window. Once you paste those in, hit configure again. When the red text turns white, you are in the clear. Hit generate and then open project. I mean, in an ideal situation. It is possible that your configuration sort of ignores SDL2 there, forcing you to fill up everything there manually. Do it. It takes just a minute and, well, it is mandatory if you want to proceed and play your own Doom. Ready to open project. This will launch Visual Studio. You don't need to write a single line of code here. Just compile Chocrete Doom and keep your fingers crossed. Looking good. But we cannot run it yet. Well, it will crash immediately. This brings us to the DLLs. The executable we build needs those SDL helper files to actually talk to Windows. Go back to your downloaded SDL folders and copy the DLL files. SDL2 DLL, SDL2.NET DLL, and SDL2 Mixer DLL. Paste them right next to your new Chocrete Doom EXE in the release folder or debug folder. Thinking that this is all? Wrong. The game is data. In Doom terms, this is the WAD file. Fun fact, WAD stands for Where's All the Data? Since the original Doom data is copyrighted, you can just download it for free legally. If you own the game, you should. Copy your Doom WAD file over. If you don't, download a shareware version and use that. Everything looks to be working. Go ahead and play around. Experience it. You can even use debug mode and step through any logic you are interested in, line by line. Now that we have everything set up, maybe we can try some tinkering. Before we start breaking things, let's take a quick look around. The source code might look intimidating at first, it's a lot of C files, but it uses a certain naming convention to keep it organized. If you look at a solution explorer, you'll see files starting with specific letters. These are your breadcrumbs. First, we have the D files, like D main C. This stands for Doom main. This is the heartbeat of the engine, handling the startup arguments and the main loop. Then you have the P files. This stands for play. This is where the magic happens. Like P MOBJ handles moving objects, basically anything that moves like player and monsters. PNME contains the actual brain code for the monsters. If you want to make the imp smarter or the Cyberdemon faster, this is your playground. Next are the R files, standing for the refresh or render. This is the graphics engine. R main C and R draw handle drawing the walls, floors, and sprites to your screen. And finally, the I files. These are the interface files, like iVideo, C. This is the hardware layer where the game talks to your operating system. In Chocri Doom, this is where the SDL code lives, translating Doom's instructions into something Windows understands. Let's play. Why settle for 100% health? That's boring. To be stylish, let's give ourselves 666 health by default. You see, Chocri Doom isn't just code, it respects history. It uses an internal system called DHECT to manage the game's vital statistics. Back in the 90s, DHECT was a hacky external tool used to patch the executable. Here, it's built right in. If we change the value here, the engine will politely propagate it almost everywhere. Search for the macro default initial health. Right now, it sits at a standard value of 100. Let's change that to the mark of the beast, 666. Now rebuild and run. Congratulations, you have fundamentally altered the laws of the game universe. The game now considers 666 to be the correct state of being. You spawn with it, you heal up to it, and you are ready to face the legions of hell on their own terms. One small detail though. This change isn't propagated everywhere. There are still some UI elements or limits that might need tweaking. I'm leaving that fix to you as an exercise. Next, want to walk around without being bothered? Let's tune the monsters so they simply never see you. Open PEnemyC. Search for the function called ALook. This function is the eyes of the enemy. It is the routine every idle monster runs constantly to check if a player has wandered into view. We are going to short-circuit it. Right at the beginning of the function, just return. Now the monsters are effectively blind. They are just standing there, daydreaming. You can walk right up to it and high-five him. He won't react at all until you actually shoot him and trigger his pain state. It's a very surreal way to explore the maps. And finally, let's make the boss fight a nightmare. We are going to mess with the entity definitions. Open info.c. This file is the DNA of the game. It is a massive table that defines the stats for everything. Health, damage, reaction time, and speed. Search for empty cyborg. This is a Cyberdemon. Look at his stats columns. You will see the number 16. That is his speed in map units per frame. Let's change that to something crazy, let's say 100. Rebuild the game and run it. To test this quickly, we need to warp straight to the boss level. Once the game loads, just type the cheat code IDCLEF28 on your keyboard. That will teleport you instantly to episode 2, mission 8. Careful, you need the official registered Doom WAD for this level. The shareware version stops after episode 1. When you get there, good luck. There we have it. We went from a raw folder of C files to a custom built, compiled, and mutated version of history's most legendary shooter. We didn't just play Doom today, we owned it. And that is the real power of open source. You aren't just a player anymore, you are a mechanic. If you want a shotgun that shoots BFG rounds, write it. If you want aims that fly, code it. The blueprint is right there, waiting for you. I hope this gives you the confidence to stop being afraid of the compiler and other people's projects. Go break some code and make something cool. And if you like Doom, you can watch this video where we spiced up Duck Hunt. Thanks for watching. If you want to see more in the future, don't forget to subscribe. Ciao!